Hey folks, Matt from ArtOfTheImage.com. Very, very interesting suggestion or comment or wish from one of our viewers regarding what Canon should do on a new camera, on what they should do, as he puts it, to leave Panasonic in the dust. So what do we have here? We have Jason Chavez. Hope I'm reading that right, or pronouncing that right, I should say. This is a comment on one of the videos. He says, Canon, if you want to pull the mat out under Panasonic's feet and leave Sony in the dust, listen extremely carefully to what I'm about to write. Number one, BSI 24 megapixel APS-C dual pixel autofocus, 2.4K, 60 frames per second, 10-bit usable Kodak. Don't you dare pull the 5D Mark IV card on us again. No crop or retarded codec, he says. So number two was 4K. I read that wrong. Number one, BSI sensor, 24 megapixels, dual pixel autofocus. Number two was 4K, 60 frames a second, 10-bit usable codec. Number three was 1080p, at least 120 frames per second. Please, not a soft 1080p. Number four, keep the swivel screen. Number five, dual card slots. Number six, 12 frames per second shooting mode with a good raw buffer. Number seven, no overheating issues or recording limit. Number eight, sensor stabilization, dual IBIS. Number nine, video recording aids, Zebra, focus peaking, full HDMI. Number 10, add the joystick to change focus points. Number 11, a better low light performance. Number 12, some good color profiles, including C-Log. Number 13, better battery life. Number 14, a competitive price point. Knowing you, Canon, you'll give it to us $500 more than the GH5. 15, enhanced preamps for audio. You will create the best hybrid camera for the next 2 to 3 years. But if you have dignity to shell out your next camera only with 1080p, brace yourselves because you will start a riot like never before. And if you find this list too complicated, just get the GH5 body in a Canon 24 megapixel dual pixel 4K sensor with no crop and give the people what they want. That's a great comment, great commentary, great wish list from Jason here. And you know what? That would be an amazing camera. Could we see it in a future 7D? Future version of the 7D? Yeah, maybe. A 90D? My God, I would love this to be the 90D. However, it's just too good. Canon just wouldn't do this. They wouldn't give us this much good stuff in a 90D at that price point. I could see something entirely new, perhaps. Maybe they come out with a mirrorless APS-C with all of these features aimed at, like Jason says, going after Sony and Panasonic. Because that would be killer. I would pay GH5S pricing for that camera. $2,500? Done. Done deal. And then I've got all the beautiful Canon lenses I love. I've got dual pixel AF. I've got 4K. I've got great image quality at APS-C. And got the flip-out screen. Everything. That would be fantastic. Jason has nailed it. But what do you guys think? Do you agree? I mean, you could tell I do. Has Jason nailed it here? Is this the camera you want? Is this the camera that would crush Panasonic, crush Sony from Canon? Maybe we should see if Canon can give us a kickback for taking care of all their R&D for the next 3 years. Anyways, thanks, Jason, for this. This is great. A little humor in there, too. Want to hear what you guys have to say? Let me know in the comments below. Is this your camera? Is this the one you would buy? Is this what Canon needs to do? Would this camera knock out Panasonic and Sony? Would Canon be totally dominating everything with this camera? Let me know. Let's talk about it in the comments below. Very interested to hear what you guys have to say. This was what Jason wants. And I'm saying, yeah, that's what I want too. But I want to hear what you guys have to say. Thanks for tuning in. Stay tuned. We'll be back soon here at ArtOfTheImage.com.